NaHCO3. How do you name that compound and what are the radicals present? Na is alone. What do you call a substance that has Na? Na is a symbol for what?
Sodium.
And then H is for what?
Hydrogen.
And then CO3 is what?
Carbonate.
A carbonate. Very good. Now, a carbonate is supposed to be having two. But because of the hydrogen, it has combined. How do you call a radical that has a hydrogen and a carbonate on it? Radical with hydrogen carbonate. So how do you read number one? What's the name of that compound? Somebody read for me the part A. How do you, what is the name of that compound? You people.
Hydrogen carbonate.
With what? There is something I've missed out. What?
Sodium hydrogen carbonate.
Thank you very much. Somebody read for me number B part. B part. B part.
Organism hydrogen carbonate.
Very good. Now we are in the system. What about C part? C part? B is what? BA. We don't have BA in the paper.
Barium.
Yes, it is barium. Thank you very much. So what is the name of that compound? Is it called barium nitrogen oxide?
Barium.
Speak with confidence. Don't hide. Yes?
It's barium nitrate.
Thank you. B part. Next one here. How do you call that? John, where are you? John. Give me the name of this substance. What is the name of this compound? Is what? NH4 is what? NH4.
Ammonium sulfate.
That's ammonium sulfate. Then this one, E part. Is it called what? Potassium chloride oxide. Potassium chloride oxide. Is that the name? Where are these people? You mean there are not people in this page? What's the name of this? On that paper we have, there is CLO3 somewhere. Does it have a name?
Hmm?
ClO3, it is somewhere on the radicals. It is in valence one. Have you seen it?
Chlorate.
It is a chlorate. So how do you name, or what's the name of this substance?
Potassium.
Potassium chlorate. Thank you. Uh-huh. Now, if they ask you for, like this one, that state the radicals present in the following compounds. NA is a cation, a positive one. So the radicals and the negative ions present in that compound. This is what we have here. So what is the radical present here? Let me see. Hmm? This is a nitrate radical, isn't it? Yes? John, which radical is here? In B.
It is nitrate.
Then B, here. You said ammonium sulfate. How many radicals are there, and which ones are those? How many are they? There are two. We have ammonium and sulfur, isn't it? So we have ammonium radicals and sulfur radicals. You will put it. Okay. Now, our main point of discussion was this today. And I want somebody to be reading for us and discuss and leave. There's that subtopic down. Is it clear on your side? Yes? The one on the camera.
Yes.
How would you read this? Yes. From this word classes? Uh-huh. Let me just choose because it's for fear and to read. Let me choose. Hope.
Yes.
Read for us.
Yes.
Read for us from here up to the end of the page.
There are various classes of chemical reactions, and a few of these will be considered. Combination reaction. This takes place when two or more substances combine to form a single substance. For example, when a mixture of iron and sulfur is heated, iron two sulfide is formed.
Thank you very much. Now, what do you call that type of chemical reaction?
Combination reaction.
So when two or more substances combine to form a single substance. An example they have given us here is iron and what? Iron and what?
Sulfur.
And sulfur. If the two are mixed together and heated, they form iron two sulfide. This is the first type of chemical reaction. Just direct. When this takes place, when two or more substances combine to form a single substance, two or more. Actually, these are two. The first one is this. This is the second one. When they combine, they form a substance called iron sulfide. That's what they form. Now, another example is what? Which other one can we take? Two or more substances combine to form a single one. Can you tell us another one? A combination reaction. Think of any first. Yes, Pab.
Hydrogen and oxygen.
hydrogen and oxygen. Very good. Elizabeth. Elizabeth.
Yes.
Another example of a combination reaction where two elements combine to form one. Uh-huh.
My wife is not a bad person. There's something happy by Marita.
Who is that one watching movies? Elizabeth, you are the one.
Marita decided to quit the profession because she loves it so much.
Okay, Hope. Hope, give us another one.
Sodium chloride.
Sodium chloride. What are the two elements that combine to give us sodium chloride? What do you add to what to get sodium chloride?
Sodium and chlorine.
Sodium and chlorine. Very good. Uh-huh. Who else has not talked? Sean. Another example.
Yes, teacher.
Another example.
Calcium, chlorine.
Very good. Stuart. 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 This is there was somebody of this name. Okay, examples of those reactions are here. Are they clear on your side?
Yes.
So number one is saying complete the following equations. The first one, what's the product form?
Manganese oxide.
Magnesium oxide.
Not
magnesium oxide.
Okay. Magnesium oxide. What is the formula of magnesium oxide? I want the formula.
MgO solid.
MgO solid. Very good. B part says hydrogen plus oxygen. What is the end product?
Hydrogen oxide.
Hydrogen oxide. How do you get that hydrogen oxide? How do you write water in chemistry?
H2O.
H2O.
Liquid.
Yes. So when hydrogen combines oxygen, the end product is water. Water is H2O. Okay? So when they ask you for water, you just write H2. That 2 is a subscript down there. So it's H2O. Then you balance. When you zinc reacts with sulfide, what do you form? Zinc and sulfur, what do you form?
Zinc sulfide.
Zinc? Zinc what?
Sulfide.
Sulfide, very good. B part, what is the product of B part? Sodium and chlorine. What do you get? Hmm?
Sodium chloride.
Very good. When hydrogen combines with chlorine, what do you form? Hydrogen? Chloride. Very good. Somebody give me the code, the whatever of hydrogen chloride. How do you write hydrogen chloride? Hmm?
Capital H.
Mm-hmm.
Capital CA.
Hmm. CL. Thank you very much. When is zinc and a chloride chlorine react, what do you form? F.
Zinc chloride.
Zinc chloride.
Zinc chloride.
Give the name, this is number two. Give the name or names of the products of the following reactions. Sodium and iodine, what do we form? Sodium and iodine, what do we form? Hmm? We don't know. Ruth. Ruth. Ruth.
Can I pass?
Yes.
Sodium ions.
Sodium? Before you go there, when sodium and chlorine react, what is the end product?
Sodium chloride.
Sodium chloride. When sodium reacts with iodine, what is the end product?
Sodium iodide.
Sodium iodide. Very good. What is the formula of sodium iodide? You have an iodide radical somewhere.
NaL.
N?
N? I.
N-A?
I.
I is capital or small?
Capital.
Okay. When copper and oxygen react, what do you form?
Copper oxide.
Copper oxide. Very good. Somebody read this. Sean. Sean?
Yes, teacher.
Read for us Roman 2.
Roman decomposition reaction.
Wait a little. Okay.
This occurs when a compound splits up into simpler substances. Mm-hmm. This change usually takes place without the presence second substance, and very often the action of heat is sufficient to cause the reaction to take place. For example, when copper 2 carbonate is heated, it decomposes to copper 2 oxide and carbon dioxide.
So, in simple terms, when they ask you a decomposition reaction, what are they trying to mean with out of what somebody has read? Some person else, when they say decomposition reaction, use your own words, they don't want you to follow what is here. When they say decomposition reaction, what does it mean? Decompose. When they say decompose, what does it mean?
Breaking.
What do you use for breaking? In chemistry, use a hammer? Yes?
No.
What do you use in chemistry to decompose something? What do we use? Yes. We use heat to decompose. Okay. When they say decomposition reaction, or then they say to decompose something, what you get is what? What do you use for heating in the lab?
Constant burn.
Bunsen burner. So when you want to decompose something, light a Bunsen burner and heat. They give you a salt of copper 2 carbonate and they tell you to go and decompose it. What you do, get the salt, put in a test tube and you go and heat. When you heat, this is what will happen. It will decompose to copper 2 oxide and carbon dioxide what? Gas, isn't it? Now, this one, before you heat, it's green. Copper 2 carbonate is green. When you heat, it will turn to black. That black compound is called copper 2 oxide and a colorless gas. That turns lime water milky will be seen. Do you know how to test for carbon dioxide?
Yes.
What do you use?
Lime water.
Very good. When you add lime water to it, what happens?
It turns milky.
Turns milky. Very good. Let's look at what happens in the decomposition. Copper carbonate. Let me share with you this so that you don't waste time there. When you find it, you just write what is there. This is the decomposition what? Reaction. This is what's going to happen. When you heat or decompose a metal carbonate, anything, a metal carbonate, you know metals?
Yes.
An example is copper. Copper is a metal. Another element is? Another metal?
Iron.
So when you heat their carbonates, the end product is an oxide and carbon dioxide gas. So this one is the color of this. This is white in color. So when you decompose, do you see something that's down here?
Yes.
This is our flame. Which type of flame is this?
Non-luminous.
Non-luminous. Let me ask someone. Ruth? Ruth?
Yes, teacher.
Uh-huh. Is it true that it's non-luminous?
Yes.
Okay. So. When you hit this, you see the black solid coming up. Okay, this one symbolizes the presence of an oxide. Now the carbon dioxide in the substance is escaping, leaving us with a black oxide. That's what you're going to observe down there. So finally, if you hit if the whole solid has got enough heat, the carbon dioxide will leave. Now this is our lime water. When you heat the carbonate, you lead that gas to our lime water using a delivery tube or something else. The end product is the milkiness here. That milk substance shows the presence of